Alright, so I thought I'd just do a video showing everything in my turtle room, and so I guess I can just start now. So first thing we've got here is our incubators, and in these incubators we've got 8 total eggs, and we've got the female incubator there on the left, and we've got the male incubator there on the right. I'm unsure right now of which eggs are fertile, but it looks to be that all of the females are incubated are fertile, and maybe one that's not. And then over here it looks like there's only one that is, and maybe that one might not also be fertile either. So fingers crossed. She's got more eggs in her too. She laid about a week ago, a week ago from today. So I'm hoping she lays again soon. She laid 12, but only 8 made it because she ate one and 3 others cracked. So that's up with that. Next, we've got just some racks sitting on the wall, and we'll start here. We've just got, turtle food for the adults. We've got filter parts, we've got silicone, PVC piece, and we've got some filter pads for the filters, of course. We've got carbon. I purchased 6 pounds of carbon. That also goes in the filters. We've got hatchling food, just simple Zoomed hatchling food, calcium, and that was supposed to go in the filter, but I didn't put it in. And then we've got just random containers and incubating and boxes and stuff up there. So that's what's on my turtle rack, I guess. And then next we've got our pond. And you guys have seen plenty of this. I put a PVC in there just to make it so it's not sloshing and making so much noise. But right now I've only got the female in there because she doesn't seem to want to breed with the male too often, so I separated the male. You'll see him in a little bit. So I'm hoping that'll make her want to breed a little bit more. And so like I said, you guys have seen this, but it's 7 feet by 3 feet total, including the sand area. Sand area is 3 feet by 2 feet. Just got wetted down sand. We've got our little ramp right there with the mercury vapor bulbs. I've got mercury vapor bulbs on every single bulb, on every single tank I've got. So if I forget to mention that, they've all got their UVA and UVB that they need. Over here, we've got it filtered by the CFS 500, and then filtered into my Skippy, it's my Skippy. And I also put another bottom part of a 5-gallon bucket. I didn't put that in the tutorial, but I drilled a bunch of holes, so it's filtered throughout the entire filter. It's not just coming down through one central area from the hose. And that was thanks to Alex G on Facebook. He gave me that idea after he watched my video and made one for himself. And then we've got our tank over here just hanging out. We've got a couple PVC pieces and liner and our siphons for water changes and overflow. And I'm going to be setting this up here within the next couple weeks or so. I just haven't gotten around to setting anything up in there. That's going to be the wet-dry filter. And if you guys are interested in the wet-dry filter, I will make a video on that. So if you guys want to see a wet-dry filter, then let me know. Here we've just got a 5-gallon bucket and a humidifier. I've got a humidifier just because there's so much water in here that it makes so much humidity, and mold can grow really, really easily. So I've got a pretty nice humidifier. It was a couple $100. So I've got to empty that pretty much daily. Here we've got our hatchling tank. Not really much in it right now. We've just got our lubinos, and I'll do a separate video on them in probably a week, 2 weeks, somewhere in there. They're growing fast. The male's at 2.5 inches, and the female is at 2 inches, so this tank part does need to be cleaned as well. Again, filtered by Sun filter. It's got the mercury vapor bulb. It's kept at 85 degrees for really nice growing, and speeds up their metabolism, so they eat really well and grow really well. It baths frequently, and it's got this bark. I like this bark a lot. It's got this bark, and that's where they bask on up in there. It's pretty nice. I like it. It makes the water a little darker, kind of more natural, more Amazon-y, I guess. I like it, but it can get out of hand in the beginning, so you gotta do some water changes pretty frequently when you get your bark, but it looks decent right now, I guess. I mean, it's clear and all, so that's good, I guess. Next we've got just another 40-gallon breeder. Oh yeah, that's a 40-gallon breeder. We've got another 40-gallon, and it's just housing my caramel. I just moved them in. This doesn't even have a filter in it. I set this tank up last night, or the night before that, one or two. It's just a temporary setup. It's also holding the male albino. Like I said, I'm taking him out to make the female want to breed more, just because she is not showing much interest. And I need to get the eggs fertile, and she's got to breed with him to do that, obviously. And it just got a little pump in there, but I'm going to most likely move them into the 55-gallon. Once I get all that set up, I'll probably show you guys a video on that. And I'll get the hatchling albinos that are hatching out of the incubator and put up a setup in here. I'll probably do a video on them. And if I can get a video of them actually hatching, that'd be pretty cool too. But it's a pretty long process. It can take up to several hours, and I've heard even days. So I don't know if my camera battery can hold that, but that's the room. Oh, and I will do a separate video on incubator and what it looks like on the inside. I copied my buddy Joe. He's got the same incubators. He just hatched what, like two spotted, I think, out of this exact incubator. So I'm hoping to do the same with my albinos. He's a really cool guy. Really nice. I'll link his channel when I do that video, and I'll get that video out here pretty soon. But yeah, that's the turtle room. If you guys saw pictures, I posted on Facebook what it looked like before, but it was pretty trashy. It was just pretty much a storeroom, and we just had a bunch of crap in here. But I think it looks pretty nice. It's gonna hold some pretty nice stuff, and I hope to get some pretty nice stuff in here in the future, other than just albinos. But yeah, that's the room. Thanks for coming, watching. Hope you guys liked it. I will catch you guys later.